Back to you.
Deirdre, I've already screwed up presentation over here.
You're already getting in trouble on this side of the table. Mm-hmm. Over here, we're doing all right so far. It's 8:42, and in honor of Cinco de Mayo, we thought it might be fun to have two local restaurants come in and show us their special recipes for guacamole, because that's the biggest thing people want on this day, I think.
Yeah.
So Roberto Timoteo is here from Napolitos in East Sacramento. Been there for a long time. Thank you. And you can go ahead and get started there, Roberto. And Ryan Rose is here from Zocalo.
Yes, I am.
Well, so, I got to tell you already off the bat, it's wonderful. Your guacamole.
Appreciate it. Seven in the morning with breakfast, a little
cereal
and guacamole, that goes well.
Oh, yeah, we get up early, so it's all good. So, Roberto, what are your, and go ahead and start making it, but what are your secrets to making good guacamole?
Well, I put the ingredients, tomatillos, and avocados, garlic, salt, pepper, cumin, and lime juice.
And lime juice. All right, well, go ahead and get started, because we know you want to start making it.
Okay.
And we'll just kind of watch you as you're doing that. And I was noticing that you were incredibly quick at getting all the avocados pitted and cleaning it up and making it a good start.
Okay.
So you're cutting it in half, and then it just
pops
right
out? Yeah, you just the spoon.
Okay. Well, there's a good. Do you need a spoon?
Yeah, I need a spoon.
Brian has one right here.
I got one for you.
We're there we go. Okay. See, look how nice our chefs are sharing over there. And how about you, Ryan? What are some of your secrets?
You know, when you're doing a guacamole, it's almost all the same basic ingredients. You can do little touches here and there. Mm-hmm. We like to add a little bit of jalapeno vinegar.
It has a kick to it.
Yeah, there's a little jalapeno vinegar in it, and that really just boosts the flavors. And you can never go wrong with a little salt as well. You know, salt really brings all those flavors together.
Yeah, well, go ahead and keep cooking.
Sure,
we don't want to slow
you
down.
We got you white, and you also have a little radish on top.
Got a little radish, give it a nice little crunch. You know, the avocados give it a great texture of nice smoothiness.
While we have you there, is there a trick? You just cut it over
you
and
open
just,
it.
Okay.
Push this out.
There you go.
Kind of just.
Is it true that if you leave the pit in the guacamole once you make it, it helps keep it fresh?
Could.
Have you heard that?
I'm not saying you're wrong, though.
Just a little weird, but I've heard that that actually kind of helps. How do you tell a really fresh guacamole when you're in the grocery store?
You know, you want to, I guess when I go and I shop.
Fresh avocado, rather, sorry.
I'm looking for a color of the skin. So you don't you don't want it to be too dark of a brown.
Mm-hmm.
And then you touch it. So you're looking for any kind of bruising.
Yeah.
Just like anything, any fruits or vegetables, when you're looking, you're kind of touching
it. See on how hard it is, whatever.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
All righty. So Roberto's still working on it over there. And so you throw in tomatoes, lime juice, and then little jalapeno, and then radishes on top, right?
Right, I got the little radish. Now, what I did bring, we don't put in ours at the restaurant, but if you like a nice
little
kick,
extra spicy.
I got a habanero chili here.
Okay.
And I would put a little touch in that because this stuff goes a long way. It's one of the hotter peppers around. So you could definitely throw that in there and give it a nice spicy flavor as well.
And when I'm at home, how many avocados are you doing, like, for example, for these two bowl sizes?
For this one, you're probably doing five avocados, and you do probably two tomatoes. And
I'm holding up progress over here, so I'll let you get back to do it.
Cool.
Roberto is flying along, though. This looks great.
Thank you.
All right. Well, we've let the chefs here continue, and we'll have a little taste test here by the end of the show.